brief update about what I have been doing all this long. So initially I was planning Ladakh, and then after that I was doing Ladakh, going about the ride straight away. I started off on 16th August, right after our Independence Day, and a few tips and tricks to start off a ride. I started very early, so I started at 4:30, 4:35 to be specific, and that went pretty well. So by around 9:30ish, I had already completed half of the journey. So I was at Dharampur. So the plains ended around 200 kilometers.
Searching for a longer day. People feeling like the light has just come. We must never stop the way. Yeah. Birds chirping and I hear my name. Grasping into a life. Life is happy but it's so insane. We must merely make a start. Savannah, I'm coming home. Savannah, we'll never be alone. Savannah, the beauty of the world. Savannah, let's all take a walk. Savannah.
Less than 100 kilometers left for Rampur. That's the destination for the day. And the view is this. If you guys can, if you want to enjoy it. First day went pretty well. Yes. These are all the places I saw while on the way to Rampur. It was not the sort of challenge for me the first day, but it was more of a practice. So, and I was enjoying it at the same time. It went pretty well. Ended at Hotel Shangri-La, right in the start of Rampur Bushehr. It's an amazing hotel. The view is moderate. For me it was amazing. For some people who are used to the views of mountains with swimming pool and all of that stuff, all of the luxury stuff, you won't be getting the luxury stuff over there. But for me it was amazing. I had riverfront. It was a nice hotel room with a nice bed, a cozy bed, a clean, hygienic state. And the staff was very helpful in telling me that the route ahead is not functional. So the route ahead, Nako, my next day was going towards Kinnaur. Kinnaur is where you enter, you start entering Spiti.
The initial day, the first day was amazing in terms of the riding. But it turns out route ahead of Nako is closed due to a huge landslide, so I have to take a reroute towards Manali. That's the original route. So I've got the permits ready online yesterday, and seems like I'll be reaching Manali today. Let's hope so, in time. And tomorrow I'll be crossing Rohtang. And there onwards, that's the usual route. We'll be doing Leh and all of that other thing. For now, this is the view as a very good fucking morning!
Light's gonna come. The birds have just begun. We will always take a stand for the people, for the land. Let's go back. Savannah, I'm coming home. Savannah, we'll never be alone. Savannah, the beauty of the world. Savannah, let's all take a ride. Savannah.
Jalori Pass. Last, we have reached Jalori. This is the view.
Opener for me, because I was going to see a lot of similar stuff ahead, so that was sort of a practice. And you'll be able to see, I met this guy at Jispa and he said this, so these were his words. if you have done Jalori, there is nothing to worry about ahead. I was not worrying about anything, but Jalori was nothing. Like, it was 5 kilometers of slush towards the pass, and after the pass there was no road at all. It was just loose gravel, but it was very tough. I had to go downhill in neutral just on my brakes, and midway in between for like 2-3 kilometers I had to start the bike and put it in second so that I have some momentum going on. I don't just stall. I came across this group from Maharashtra. This group had a Versus 650, I guess a couple of Dukes, a Himalayan, a Classic, and an RC. All of the people were very nice or were looking decent, but the moment we started off, the guy on Versus, he was pretty rude, man. He was pretty rude. Guys, when you are traveling in Himalayas or the mountains, we must understand that there's a lot to it. So we should not be rude. So they were traveling in a group. I was traveling solo. I wanted to make sure I don't push them off, or I don't push on, pile on them. So I asked for pass. I just honked, and this guy was like this, and my usual tendency is to let things go. Yes, I'm lying, but that's what I'm supposed to say, right? I let it go. Then I honked again and I wanted pass. So it was like this. And I passed and I did this. So my point of saying this to you, or my point of telling all of this to you guys is, when you're traveling to a place far away from your home, even though you have like 15 people around you, try to make sure you don't piss anyone off, or you don't mess with anyone. I'm not saying be scared or stay scared. All I'm saying is try to be as kind, as happy going as possible, because that'll only add up to the whole experience. It personally helps me a lot. So that's about it. From there onwards, I proceeded towards Manali, and that route was again love. This is the word I have for these kind of routes. Curvy roads, clean roads, all the mountains, all the rivers, everything you see on that route, it's amazing.
Sort of having lunch, sort of a brunch here.